Good morning, everybody. I welcome you all to your literature class. In the previous video, students, we have learned about lesson number 4. And we have also seen in that lesson how Japanese were forcing the Koreans to adapt a new name, to take a new name, to take a new culture, to take the new traditions and forget about their old traditions. And in this chapter especially, we will understand how difficult it was for them to accept a new name. So we have covered till para 11. I'll be reading from the 12. Till para 11, we have seen that one girl is there whose name is Kyoko according to the Japanese. And when she goes to the class, she finds it very difficult. In the early days, it was easy for her to do it. But as the days passes, she found it very difficult, dear children, to manage with the new name. And she made a mistake in front of one army officer. This was also explained to you in that video of mine. And here we will see when teacher calls her to the front of the class. Now let's see what happens after that. So it says from 12th para, the class was suddenly silent. I could see the surprise in the faces of the other students. After all, I was daughter of vice principal and I had never been beaten before. In this line, student, she explains that she is daughter of principal, that is vice principal, I mean. And children, whoever, suppose if you are a student, if you are a child of any teacher, then you have to be very, very careful in the school, because teachers are like a role model to children, am I right? And because of which their kids also have to behave in a very good way. They should be well mannered. You cannot misbehave, as everybody will tell you, oh, look at this boy, he's this so and so man's son or daughter. So in that case, you people have to be little careful. And this girl, she was the daughter of vice principal, and she says that I have never ever got beaten. And the class was silent. Why they were silent? Because it is not that any other child was going to get punishment, but it was the girl of vice principal. In the brief moments it took me to walk to the front of the class, I saw the teacher's face. She looked so unhappy. I felt sorrier for her than for myself. She didn't want to beat me, but she had to, because only she Sam was there. So she explains here that in the brief moments it took me to walk to the front of the class. Quickly she got up from the place and moved in the front so that she could stand in front of everybody. And she saw the teacher's face. You know, children, it is not that we can express our feeling only by our words. We can express them by our expressions too. And when this girl saw the face of the teacher, what she experienced, she looked so unhappy. The expression of the that teacher was like she was not at all happy beating this girl. She was not finding it interesting at all or finding it good at all. And she looked so unhappy that I felt sorry. It says that girl is feeling sorry not for herself that she is getting beaten, oh I am getting beaten, no. She is feeling sorry for the teacher, because the expression shows that teacher is not at all happy, but she has to do it as Onishi-san was there in the class. It was so unfair. First our names were taken away and then we were not given any time to learn each other's new name. She says all these things are going on in her mind. She's thinking it is so, you can say, unfair thing. We have not got any justice. When we were enjoying with our culture, we were having such good names, we were having everything nice, then why we are forced to take these things? Forced to take all the things according to Japanese culture and everything, name, whatever things were there. Now she's thinking that isn't it unfair with us? Although everything was imposed on us that we have to do. Imposed means something forcefully, somebody tells you to do something. So it was forced on us and we were not even given time to learn those things. Yes, really, children, I think this was really unfair according to this girl. At least whenever we have to learn something, we are given time by parents, by teachers, whoever it may be. Whatever time we need to learn that thing, we are given. Then only it is possible. It is not possible within a day we can learn so many things. So here also the girl says it looked very unfair that we have to learn each other's new names. Not only culture, but even new names which are really difficult to learn. And then on page number, you will come to the next page. It says, para 50. So when the bamboo cane whisked through the air, I was angry. I was not frightened that I will be getting beaten. The expression is written here, I was angry. That anger was there in the girl. Why she was angry? Because she was thinking, we were not given any time to learn. We were not given anything that, what you can say, it is of our favor. Only we have to do what they want us to do. So when the bamboo cane, cane means a sort of stick which is used for beating, and it was of bamboo tree, and swished is a sound when you whip something, when you hit with something, that sound, crashing sound which you can hear, sweeping movement through the air. If you have no experience of this, you just take one stick and try to hit like this in air, you will find that it will create some sort of sound. And not, she said, I was not frightened, but I was angry. With each stinging shrap, the word ran. With each stinging, sting is, you know what? Sting is a dung, you can call that sting. And bee sting, you know, bee stings. Yes. So that pain she could feel with every sound of heavy stick. Every time when the teacher was raising the stick to beat her, and when she was beating, that sound which she could hear and that pain she could feel, the word rang in her mind. She was constantly thinking of one word, that was unfair, 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 and unfair. Best of all, I was too angry to cry. I was not angry because I was getting beaten. I was not angry because why I am the only one who has committed this mistake. She was not at all angry for anything. She was feeling sorry for the teacher who had to do this. And she was also feeling angry because of no time given to them to learn anything. And in that anger, she was feeling like crying. In the 16th para, it says, at home that night, Omoni. Omoni is termed as mother in Korean language. Pressed her lips together when she saw the fierce red welts on my legs. Children, the meaning of welts is given. Raised red area of skin caused by being hit or formed from cuts that are healing. If you get hurt, children, you would have seen that some swollen part is there and some redness also comes there. This was the condition of the legs of this girl. And definitely our mothers are very kind and loving towards us. They don't want mother or father, they don't want us to be in pain at all. If we just get a prick just because of thorn, then also they are worried about us. Look at this girl's mother. When she saw those red and swollen part of the skin. She pressed her lips. Pressed her lips means did that expression to show or express that, oh my God, what is it? And then she soothed them with a paste made of herbs. She had some kind of paste which maybe she was using for healing the wounds and like these sort of things, and she used that. Soothe means she made feel better by applying on the wound and that part of the area where she had those marks on the body, just to give comfort and care to the girl. But the marks stayed there for several days. Now girl says they were not there for 1 or 2 days, they were there for several days, and she says, I was glad to see them. I don't think anybody feel happy looking at their wounds or the marks left of the wounds. We all feel very sad. Oh yes, that day I got hurt. We always feel sad remembering that time. But she was happy. Because why she was happy? Seeing and feeling the sore redness of those welts always made me a little angry all over again. That anger what she had in her. She is saying that whenever I am watching these wounds, I am getting that anger again which I had, what I had on that day when I was getting beaten. And what do you think, children, whom she was trying to show the anger? She was showing anger on the Japanese, although actually she cannot go and say that what you are doing, why you are doing, but what she was feeling is that anger in her. I wanted to stay angry about losing my name, but I wasn't the only one. The changing of my name made even my best friends cross. Now here another child she introduces. She talks about her friend. And here she says that I am not the only one who was angry, but my friend was also quite angry to hear this, that we have to do all these things. And the best friend was annoyed. Cross means annoyed. Annoyed means you are a little irritated, not happy with anything which was taking place. His name was Tomo and he was Japanese. This girl was Korean, but the boy was Japanese. And the boy Tomo, just see, children don't have any kind of discrimination in them. They don't feel that they are small children or they are big or they are from the poor family or rich family. They don't have these things in them. And that is why Korean and Japanese both were friends. And Japanese, this boy Tomo was also feeling sad for the girl. Although he was Japanese, but that thing he can feel, that how these people would be feeling, change of name, change of everything, how they were going through all these things. When we played together after school during those days of the name change, he had to check himself all the time. Sun he, I mean Kyoko, he kept saying. Now since this name was new to that Tomo, the boy Tomo also, and so it says that not whenever we used to play after the school, this boy finds it very difficult to say my name. Sometimes he used to speak my old name, Sun he. Then sometimes, no, you are Keoko, no, you are Koeki, something of this sort. He used to speak all the time. And most of the time he was correcting himself only, no, what I am saying, no, it is not correct, that is correct. So this was the case with the Japanese boy. And then it explains, once after correcting himself for what seemed like the 100th time, he stepped his foot in frustration. Children, when we are frustrated, can you say, when we are not able to do something, when we are trying hard to do it and to learn it, but when we are unable to do it, at that point of time we feel frustrated. So I think I have made till here clear to you, and further we will read and understand, and we will finish the explanation of this chapter number 4 in our next video. Till then, take care.